Yes, good morning students. So today we are going to discuss the MCQs from literature. First of all, a letter to God. So if we talk about a letter to God, if we are to describe this chapter in a few words, then we will say it's a This chapter is about, yes, impeccable faith in God. So, when we talk about faith, so it is about the impeccable faith in God. So, when you have faith in God, okay, it's not just the faith in God, it may be upon yourself also. When you trust your own instincts, when you have faith in yourself, when you're confident about your own hard work or self, then also you can do anything in the life. It's about faith. It's not about which God, it's about faith. Maybe faith in yourself. Okay? So have strong faith. Maybe it's a faith about on your parents, maybe faith upon your own self, or maybe on God. But choose the right person to whom you should have faith upon. That is also very important. So basically, this story is about impacting faith on God and that faith which Lenko had. Who is Lenko? Or Lenko? What is? He's a father. When everything is all right in life, then the faith we have or not doesn't matter. Our faith is tested in the times of adversities. Okay, adversities make us test the kind of faith we have in ourselves or in others or maybe in God. Okay. So adversities test our faith. So the very first thing which happens during the adversity is we lose faith upon ourselves. We give up. Okay, if we give up, then we can rely upon God. It's not that you start doubting everybody. You feel like, no, that person will not be able to do it. Then you talk to that person also. You talk to that person also. Faith means having faith and that also complete faith. So here the Lenko, the farmer, the one otherwise whose life was okay, but when the adversities came, then he resorted to only one person, that is God. Without any doubt, he writes a letter to him seeking help. He asks him to send him how much money? 100 pieces. He asks for 100 pieces. So his asking for money from God is an indication that he has faith in God. He doesn't have any doubt and he writes a letter. The letter is read by somebody. Who reads this letter? The postmaster reads this letter. Postmaster reads. Okay. And what does the postmaster do? He decides to help the farmer. Why does he decide to help the farmer? He wants that the faith of farmer should not be broken. He wants that the farmer's faith in God should remain intact. So he decides to help the farmer. But is he capable of helping the farmer with that much of money which the farmer required? He was not capable. So if you want to help somebody, it doesn't mean that you should be capable of that. So what is required to help somebody? What is required to help somebody?
Will.
What is required to help somebody? Will. So when you have the will, then you can do everything. Will, faith, then will. See the sequencing of the values which we are getting. So the the Spanulo postmaster had the will to help the farmer, and the reason or the objective of helping was selflessness. It was not selfish that today I'll be helping the farmer and tomorrow the farmer will be helping me. It's not so. So his intention is very pure. His intention is that the farmer's faith in God should not be broken. So he decides to help him, thereby taking the help of his friends, of his colleagues. And the people whom he asks for, they also help him. So eventually this postmaster is able to collect how much? He is able to collect 70 pieces. And how much he wanted? But the postmaster sends this much of money to the farmer, thinking that something is better than nothing. That farmer might be happy with at least this much of help. The postmaster thought, like even we were thinking as leaders, like the farmer would be happy that God answered this request. And then farmer, when Lenko got the help, when the letter came to his hand, when he opened the money order, and when he counted the money, first of all, when he saw the letter which had come from God, he was not at all shocked or surprised. He took it very casually. What does it again show? Faith, you know, impeccable faith. He knew this. He had no doubt that God would not help him. God would not reply him. He had no doubt. And answer to his letter came. Not only the answer, help also came. But when he counted the money was less. Again, he had no doubt upon God that he sent him less money. Again, impactful faith. He never ever realized that God sent him less money. The very first doubt went to the people around him. He thought like the people in the post office, they were a bunch of crooks, those who had kept a part of the help which God had sent to him. Got it? So here, farmer got the help from who? Now answer me some questions. Story we all know now. A few questions. Question number one. Who helped Lenko?
Post office employees.
Did he ask the post office employees to help him? Did the post office employees know him? Why did the post office employees help farmer? On the name of God. In the name of God. Even if he had not read the letters, like something like related to God, if I ask you in the end one question again, who helped Lenko? Was it the office employee or was it God himself? God sent him help. God doesn't come on its own on this earth. He delegates help. He helps people. He helps humanity through humanity. Okay? God has his way to help us. God himself doesn't come directly wearing that crown and all those, you know, fancy, whatever we imagine our God to be like. Okay, all of us have our own image of God, isn't it? Somebody imagines God to be in form of Ram, somebody as a Rahim, somebody as a Vaheguru. So all of us have one kind of image in mind, isn't it? And God doesn't come like that, in that very fancy imagination. God is there in the form of human beings. Sometimes you never know, you will see God in a beggar lying around. Maybe the God is testing you, whether you are kind or not. And sometimes that very beggar might be the one who is taking the help directly from God in your form. When you are helping the beggar, thinking like he is a God, but actually maybe he is getting direct help from God in your way, from you. Maybe you are a God for him. So actually God is It's not like God is there or here or there. God is in us, in all of us. So it's not that is a God. God would have actually helped this Lambo. God actually helped Lambo through the post office invoice. So God only helped. One thing you should do. So who helped God? Sorry, who helped Lambo? God himself. So there are so many stories related to this very concept. So what I was talking about? And here, let me tell you. The chat is also closed, but they could raise hand. Yes, children, you people could have raised hand. Is that option open for you or not? Raise hand, some of you. If you are listening to me, raise hand. Yeah, Arshin is listening. Arshin, why didn't you raise hand earlier? The moment you people raise, yeah, now they are all raising hand. So why didn't you raise hand earlier? Chat is, I guess, closed. Okay, you can chat with me now. Okay. Okay, whenever there is some trouble, raise hand. So whatever we talk about, the whole story is over. Okay, children, anyways, you know all these things. But let me just repeat only the one question, which is the main one, which has come up after this whole lecture. Like, who helped Lenko? God. God helped Lenko through the post office employees. Because God doesn't come on his own in his in that fancy dress the way we imagine him to be. God comes through us. God is in all of us. God is in humanity. Okay? God is in all human beings. So if the post office employee helped the farmer, it's not that it is he who was helping. It was the God in him who was helping him. Okay, when Lenko got the help, when he got less money, and he doubts the post office employees, is his doubt, you can say, justified? Is his doubt justified? His doubt that God sent him less money, and his blaming the other people around him, is it justified? Yes or no? No. How many of you say no? Okay. So why do you say no? Yes. Yes, you are very right. Your first 90% part is very correct. Like, yes. If Lenko had faith in God, then he should also have known that whatever he was getting in his life, that was all coming from God. Okay? Then the person who believes in God also believes in the existence of God in each human being. Okay? And moreover, the one who believes in God, the one who has faith in God, cannot doubt others. Okay? Your faith in God makes you a pure soul. And that pure soul cannot doubt whether others are impure or not. If it is so, something is lacking in you. And because of that only, he was not able to get 100% help. Had he been very pure from within, had he been full of love for the humanity around him, then maybe he would have been able to get 100% help through those very people who helped him 70%. It is all God's will. If God could send him 70%, then that very God could have sent him 100% also. But because there was something missing in his faith, so he got less help.
So his doubting the post of his employees was not justified, because faith in God makes us have faith in humanity also. It also teaches us to be contented with what we get, because we get what we deserve. Okay, we get what we deserve. Doesn't mean that we should stop working hard to get more. Okay, hard work is one thing else. But yes, what we get on its own by default, that is because of what we deserve. Okay, if we are getting the food to eat, if while sitting we are having all comforts, that is what we deserve because of our previous deeds. So what we will do for future or for the next time, that is what we are doing right now. Okay, so faith in God makes us realize or remember two things. Number one, to see God in all humanity. Number two, to be contented. Right? So is his complaint justified? No, it's not justified. He should have been contented with whatever he got. Okay? And moreover, if he got less, then he should have realized that there was something wrong. There was something less in his faith. He should have tried to be more faithful to God. Got it? Okay, the rest of the chapter, you know, there are so many intrinsic details. So when you get the MCQs, they would not be like direct from there. Let's see some MCQs. Yes, very simple question. Who read the letter sent by Lencho, the postmaster? Who is the author of the lesson? Okay. Yes, important question. What is the irony in this lesson? What is the irony? Let me speak out four options, then you pick up the one. What is the irony in this lesson? Lencho was sad after the hailstorm, even though he was the one waiting for a shower. Postmaster laughed at Lencho, but still helped arrange money for him. Third, Lencho blamed the post office employees who in fact helped him. There is no irony. So what's the correct option? Yes, third is the correct option. It says, Lencho blamed the post office employees who in fact helped him. Okay, that's an irony. What is irony? When the outcome is exactly the opposite to what you were expecting. We were expecting as readers that Lencho would be very, very happy on receiving the help. And if he would come to know that somebody had helped him, then he would be very thankful to him. But the outcome was exactly the opposite that we know. Okay. So the irony is, you can note it down. Lencho blamed the post office employees who in fact helped him. Okay, next question is, what did Lencho think of the post office employees? Yeah. Lencho thought of the post office employees as the bunch of crooks. What does it show us about Lencho? The options are, Lencho thought of the post office employees as the ones who are the bunch of crooks. So what does it show us about Lencho? The options are, number one, Lencho is very doubtful. Lencho has a doubt that God sent him full help, but he got less because of the people around him. Second, it shows that Lenko's faith in God is not fully pure. Lencho is not contented with what he has. Or Lencho doesn't see God in humanity. What will you say? Though C option was also correct. What did I say there? He was not contented with what he had or what he was getting. He was not satisfied. It's okay. But the most appropriate point is, because we have to choose one, the last one, that he did not see God in all humanity. That's why he blamed them for his loss. Okay? When do we blame others? We blame others when we don't have faith in God. Okay? Yeah, very simple question. Why was Lenko? Yes. Okay, sit down. So she's asking, should you people go for literal meanings or symbolic, right? Khushi, the questions will be such that the choice will be obvious. For example, this question which I right now framed for you people, here the answer was very obvious, isn't it? Wasn't it? Okay, what was the second option? Okay, so second option said, like Lenko thought, like the post of that God had sent him full money, but those people had taken some part of it. So what was the question then? He calls them bunch of crooks because of this fact. That is what is like written. That is what is obvious. But what is the underlying meaning of this? This is what we have to understand now. That is why now the things will not be that easy as the children are thinking it to be. It is true with every subject. What I'm telling you that's the correct answer. That is not like because it is symbolic, because that is what the writer is wanting us to learn. Through this story, the writer wants to tell us that God doesn't come on his own to help the humanity. God sends messengers. There are hundreds of stories on the same theme if you explore the net. There are so many messages you people might have already read on your WhatsApp chats earlier. One very common message which I used to like a lot many years ago, like once upon a time, there was an old woman who lived in the mid of the forest all alone with her son or somebody. So she used to be all alone in that forest, and she would live by all the things which were available all around. She would never need to go to the city because she had a self-reliant life over there. She was happy. But once upon a time, her son or her husband, whatever, he had a heart attack, right? So it was midnight. It was like raining like anything. So already she was in the heart of the forest. From there, she never ever used to go to city. And at that time of the night, there was no point of going to the city to get the treatment for her son. At that time, when he had a cardiac arrest. And meanwhile, on the other part of the world, in the same country, there was the best surgeon of that city. And that surgeon, you know, happened to go by plane somewhere. So he was going, and on the way, his car stopped working. He stopped because it was raining like anything. So he looked all around to take shelter, and his car happened to stop there only, where that woman lived in the heart of the forest. So that man had never seen that place ever in his life. And he wondered, like, how could he come up that place? He was going to the airport. So anyways, because at that time it was very important for him to take shelter, so he searched around, and he was surprised to see a cottage very near to his car. And he thought, wow. He went there, and the moment he knocked at the door, he found that woman opened the door, and she wanted to serve him something, but he saw that she was busy with her son or husband. He had heart attack. So he was the best heart specialist of the country, and when he saw them, he treated that person, and that person was out of danger in the morning. And in the morning, he got the message that his air ticket had been, you know, postponed. So then he could go there in that night. Like, so there was no effect on his air ticket. It had not been canceled or something. So that time he realized that actually he had gone there to help that woman, to help her son get treated. Actually, that old woman had asked God to send help, and help had come. Okay, God doesn't come on its own. God comes through us, through the humanity only. That is what the writer wants us to learn. But even if then, and in the end, if we'll be, you know, after the literal lines of the text, then it will be our mistake. But yes, if the options are out of text, then you won't have to worry. But when there is a symbolic point, then you'll definitely have to think. The CBSE will not be sending you the straightforward questions like who is the writer, who is it, who spoke this, who said this. No, there would be in-depth questions which would require you people to think from within. It is true for all subjects. Okay, so you don't need to worry. Right now in these revision tests, you'll get some idea. Then you will get better idea in the exams. Then afterwards, your first term will come in the month of November. Right? Okay, so right now you focus upon your text of all subjects. Okay, as much you are able to get, you get. Exams will give you more clear idea like what should be your thinking pattern. Right? So always seek the crux of all chapters. Okay, when you will be after the crux of the chapters, then only the things would be clearer. And yes, if there are 10 questions out of 10, 6 questions will be for all kinds of children, which normally majority of the children will be able to answer. And there will be 2 questions which will be for very, very below average students. Those who are never able to say anything, even they will be also able to answer. And 2 questions will be such which will be for the toppers. Only the ones who want to excel, only they will only be able to answer. Otherwise, they also will not be able to. Is that clear? Otherwise, what happens in the end? Everybody gets 100% and all are first. It will not happen. So the ones who will be the top 10 children, they will be actually the ones who will be deserving. Okay, so those who only cram and do the things in the end of that exams, they won't be able to do much. So only the students who are very regular, very disciplined with their studies, they will be okay. The question is, why did the postmaster decide to reply to Lenko's letter? Got it? Why did the postmaster decide to reply to Lenko's letter? The options are, he was a good man. He felt empathetic. Third option, he wanted to preserve Lenko's faith in God. And the option is, all of the above. Okay, I'm repeating. Then you remember which option. He was a good man. I guess we should not take this kind of option. He felt empathetic. What is empathetic? When you are able to see the or feel the pain of others. When you try to fit yourself in the shoes of others. That is being empathetic. He wanted to preserve Lenko's faith in God. And then all of the above. Yeah. What's the correct option? C. So this was, what kind of question is it? Symbolic or the one from the text? From text. It was the one from the text. So because it was clearly written that he wanted that Lenko's faith in God should not be shaken. So he decided to write a letter to, so he decided to help him out. Okay, what does this show us about postmaster? When he decides to do this for the Lenko, for the farmer, what does it show about the about him? Get to this side. And Saket, you get to that side. Stand up and come here. Come here, yes. Okay. Where's the phone? Is pocket mein hai. Nikalo. Check his pocket. Sit here. What does this tell us about the postmaster? That he didn't want the farmer's faith being shaken. What does it tell us? What does it tell us? Yeah, he wanted this, we know this. But what does it tell us about him? Okay. Yes, anyone else? What does it tell us about Lenko? Okay, shall I give you options? Okay. I won't be able to give many options, but let me try. It shows that the postmaster was a very God-fearing man. No? Didn't like the option? It shows that he was a God-loving man. No? No? Everybody loves God, you will say. Do you love God or do you fear God? You know, people say like, my grandmother is a God-fearing lady. What should you say rather? God-loving. We should love God. We should not be afraid of him. He's such a nice man. God is such a nice person. Why to be afraid of him? So God-loving. So we can. So can we say that he's a God-loving man? That's why he did this. Maybe, but we don't think like it is true. We don't think it is very relevant from the text point of view. Okay, third option. Okay, we'll think later on. Yes, yesterday, how many of you did not do the link? Yes, Arshin, yes.
Ma'am, actually, I tried to open, but it said that not at all responding, furthermore respond.
Arshin, I couldn't listen to you, bete.
Ma'am, am I audible?
Yeah, you are.
Ma'am, when I tried to open the link of then it just, it was written that form is not at all responding, that it is not at all accepting the responses.
Okay, I'll see that link again today, okay? I'll open up, then I'll inform you in the group, okay?
Ma'am.